हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ अशोक बगड़ा फ्रॉम डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट पार्शियल बैलेंसिंग फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ डायनेमिक्स ऑफ मशीनरी। सो आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज पार्शियल बैलेंसिंग इन सिंगल सिलेंडर रेसिप्रोकेटिंग इंजन। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस कंसिडर अ सिंगल सिलेंडर इंजन। सो लेट अस कंसिडर अ सिंगल cylinder engine. So this is a single cylinder engine. This is a line of stroke. So OC is a crank, CP is connecting rod, and this P is a piston or a slider. My dear friends, we know that our crank, which make an angle theta degree with inner dead center and rotating with omega angular speed in clockwise direction, and because of this piston, the acceleration of piston, some inertia force is acting along the line of stroke. And we know that in a single cylinder engine, primary and secondary unbalanced forces acting along the line of stroke. So my dear friends, along the line of stroke, there are two forces acting along the this line. So this is a primary unbalanced force and secondary unbalanced force. My dear friends, we know that, but in case of low and moderate speed engine, the secondary unbalanced forces is very small, and that's why we neglect it. So we have to balance only a primary unbalanced force. So this is FP is a primary unbalanced forces, and it is acting along the line of stroke. So as seen in figure, my dear friends, in this direction FP is acting. Primary unbalanced force is equal to m omega square r into cos theta. So let us understand the concept of primary unbalanced forces. My dear friends, in a simple way we can say that primary balancing means here we are not going to balance 100% balancing. We only obtain a partial balancing. That means we make a balance in a such a way that we obtain our desired output. So my dear friends, if we imagine that the mass m is attached at the crank pin, then because of this mass, some centrifugal force acting in this direction is m omega square r, and out of this this centrifugal force having two component, one is m omega square r cos theta along the line of stroke, and another one is m omega square r sin theta. So we can say that the m omega square r into cos theta is a primary force, primary unbalanced force. Okay, so let us consider some notation. M is a mass of reciprocating part in kg, omega is the angular speed of crank in radian per second, theta is the angle made by the crank with line of stroke, this is theta, l is the length of connecting rod, small r is the radius of crank. Okay. Now partial balancing of primary unbalanced force in a reciprocating engine. So my dear friends, in this case we only a balance not 100% but around 70 to 90%, and this balancing we only balance only primary forces. So here we are going to balance a primary unbalanced forces. So we know that the primary unbalanced forces, now we can balance the primary unbalanced forces. We know that in this direction primary unbalanced forces is acting m omega square r cos theta. So this is a primary unbalanced forces acting in towards the left direction, m omega square r cos theta. Okay, now if we attach mb mass at rb radius diametrically opposite to the crank, then because of this mb mass, it is placed at rb distance, so some mb omega square rb, some centrifugal force mb omega square rb is acting in this direction. Now this crank also makes an angle theta degree with the horizontal line, with the line of stroke, so this centrifugal force having two component, one is a along the line of stroke is mb omega square rb cos theta, and another component is the vertical component is mb omega square rb sin theta. Now effect of this, if we attach mb mass at rb radius here diametrically opposite to the crank, then what happened? Let us see. So effect of balancing mass. Now if we attach mb mass diametrically opposite to the crank, then what happened? The balancing mass mb produces centrifugal force m omega square r as shown in figure. And this force having two components, mb omega square rb cos theta, this one, it is along the line of stroke, and mb omega square rb sin theta, this one, it is perpendicular to the line of stroke. Now let us discuss first component, is mb omega square rb cos theta. So this component of centrifugal force due to the balancing mass mb is along the line of stroke, and it is in opposite direction to that primary unbalanced force. So my dear friends, we know that in this direction this primary unbalanced force is acting, in this direction some another force, another component is acting because of mb mass, it is mb omega square rb cos theta. Now if these two components are equal, then we can say that we have balanced primary unbalanced force along the line of stroke. So this component is responsible for the balancing the primary unbalanced force. The primary unbalanced force is completely balanced for all angular position if. Now we can say that the primary unbalanced force is completely balanced if mb omega square rb cos theta is equal to m omega square r cos theta. So here we know that there are common term is omega square and cos theta. So we obtain mb rb is mr. So if we put mb mass at rb distance in a such a way that is equal to the mr, then we can say that we can balance primary unbalanced force. Now another component, mb omega square rb sin theta. This component of centrifugal force due to the balancing mass mb, and it is perpendicular to the line of stroke. Now this component is the balance force perpendicular to the line of stroke and produced due to the balancing of primary unbalanced forces. So partial balancing of primary unbalanced forces. So if the primary unbalanced force Fp is to be completely balanced, then we know that mb rb is equal to mr. If mb rb is equal to mr, then we can say that primary unbalanced force Fp is completely balanced. Now in such case, the maximum unbalanced force perpendicular to the line of stroke is m omega square r, which is same as the maximum primary unbalanced force. So thus the effect of above method is balancing is to change the direction of maximum unbalanced force from the line of stroke to the perpendicular to the line of stroke. Now my dear friends, if we attach mb mass here at rb radius, then what happened? Then the unbalanced force along the line of stroke will be zero, but unbalanced force perpendicular to the line of stroke will be a maximum. So here we have only changed the direction of unbalanced forces. So in some cases this is required, where a machine foundation is very high strength. Thus the effect of above method of balancing is to change the direction of maximum unbalanced force from that along the line of stroke to the perpendicular to the line of stroke. In real practice, balancing is achieved by balancing only a portion of primary unbalanced force. So now we are not going to balance 100% primary unbalanced force, but we are going to balance only 70 to 90%. So the balancing mb mass is placed diametrically opposite to the crank pinion such that mb omega square rb cos theta is equal to c m omega square r cos theta. So here c is a constant and having value is less than 1. So MBRB is equal to CMR. So if we place MB mass at RB radius in a such a way that the multiplication of MBRB is become CMR, then we can say that we have balanced partially along the line of stroke, and there is also some unbalanced force perpendicular to the line of stroke. So this is known as a partial balancing. The balanced primary force, now we can say that this balanced primary force is Cm omega square r cos theta. So we know that unbalanced primary force is m omega square r cos theta, and out of this unbalanced primary force we have balanced only Cm omega square r cos theta. So if we assume C is 0.75, then we can say that out of 100% we have balanced only a 75% of unbalanced force. Now unbalanced force due to the partial balancing of primary force. Now we know that the unbalanced force along the line of stroke. So my dear friends, unbalanced force along the line of stroke. So we have unbalanced force is m omega square r cos theta, and we have added mb mass at rb radius. So in opposite direction there is a mb omega square rb cos theta. So this force is towards the left direction and this force is towards the right direction. So here we consider m omega square r cos theta minus mb omega square rb cos theta. So horizontal unbalanced force is, if we simplify, now we know that here we are not going to balance 100% primary unbalanced force, okay. So here we put MBRB is equal to CMR. So M omega square R cos theta minus CM omega square R cos theta. So if we take a common M omega square R cos theta, then we get unbalanced force along the line of stroke is in bracket 1 minus C bracket complete into M omega square r cos theta. Now similarly, the unbalanced force perpendicular to the line of stroke, we know that it is mb omega square rb sin theta. If we put the value of mbrb, then we get unbalanced force perpendicular to the line of stroke is fp is equal to cm omega square r sin theta. Now my dear friends, we know that there is a two forces. One is along the horizontal line. This is a horizontal unbalanced forces, this is a vertical unbalanced forces. So we can obtain a resultant unbalanced forces. So resultant unbalanced forces Fr is equal to under root horizontal forces square plus vertical component square. So is equal to under root Fh square plus Fp square. So we obtain under root 1 minus C bracket square into M omega square R cos theta whole bracket square plus in a bracket C M omega square R sin theta whole bracket square. So if we take a common M omega square R, then we get resultant unbalanced force Fr is equal to M omega square R in under root bracket 1 minus C bracket square cos square theta plus C square sin square theta. Now my dear friends, the resultant unbalanced force would be minimum if we differentiate this equation with respect to a C. Then we obtain the value of C is 1 by 2. So if we put the value of C is 1 by 2, then we obtain minimum unbalanced force. But in a practice, when the unbalanced force along the line of stroke is more harmful than perpendicular to it, as for instance, in a locomotive, higher value of C is consider 2 by 3 to 3 by 4. So my dear friends, 0.66%. So 2 by 3 to 3 by 4 is a preferred value for a C. Thank you.